Hello everybody, this is Ninetales Commander with episode 3 of Super Smash Bros. Alright guys, so from the title, I'm sure you guys have realized this particular video is not going to be as positive as I usually like to make them. Now, to anybody that may be watching this that is not yet subscribed to my channel, or maybe this is the first time you've heard from me, I usually like to be a very positive type of guy. Yes, I tend to look at things critically, and I try to look at things realistically, and for the most part, I tend to be a guy that tries to be very positive and optimistic about a lot of things. But of course, even somebody like me sometimes just has to look at a situation and I have to realize there is no positivity to be found here, or if there is, it's very little to be found. So what am I talking about? Well, if you've seen the title, you already know. I am talking about Nintendo's pure incompetence when it comes to the general stocking of products that they know that we as the community, well, the consumers, want to purchase. Now, it started, this seems to be a problem that's not just happening with amiibos, it seems to be happening with a lot of particular merchandise that Nintendo seems to be selling. Now, I would just like to say, at the very beginning of the amiibo lifespan, I was trying to be quite optimistic about the lack of stock that the amiibos came under. Nintendo even came out and said, "We can't believe how well these have sold. We understand that people want them, and we have to admit," I think they even said, "even our expectations have been smashed." Now, I'm guessing that was a pun to Super Smash Bros., but whatever the case is, it does seem to be that at the beginning of the amiibo lifespan, and anything for that matter, yes, I do allow some tolerance towards this sort of thing. You know, it was a brand new thing. They didn't anticipate how well these things were going to sell. And okay, most of us, we gave them the benefit of the doubt and we admitted, yeah, okay, it's a new thing. They didn't see it coming as well as they thought it was. So let's give them the benefit of the doubt. But lately, that ain't working anymore. That simply is not working anymore, because some of you may not realize this. Amiibos have actually been going on since the end of 2014. Yeah, it has been almost 3 fudging years since these amiibos came into the market, and Nintendo is well fudging aware that these things are on high demand. And yet they have learned absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing from this entire ordeal. They have claimed that they've understood that there's supply and demand with these figurines. They understand that we want to buy these things. And yet they still can't seem to get it. They can't seem to understand that these amiibos, people want to buy them. Now, it's not just been recent. This has been an ongoing problem for as long as I can remember, especially with the major names that have come out of amiibos. Zelda amiibos are one of the absolute worst. It took me a few months to finally get my hands on any of the Zelda Breath of the Wild amiibos, and while I do finally now have access to all of the Breath of the Wild amiibos that are officially released, there's still a lot of people that still can't get their hands on these things. Sure, for the most part, a lot of people have got them now. But this is 2017. This is 2017. It has been almost 3 years since amiibos came into the market. And that's just amiibos. Right, what else has fallen under this massive problem? Well, to my surprise, the Nintendo Switch, of all things, seems to be an ongoing problem. I recently read an article, I think it was on My Nintendo News, saying that if you're able to get a Nintendo Switch in Japan, it's like winning the lottery because of how fast these things are shipping, how fast these things are selling. They are selling probably faster than Sonic the Hedgehog can run, and he can run at the speed of sound, supposedly. This is ridiculous. And don't get me started on the NES Classic and the SNES Classic. Nintendo, I don't understand exactly how you still don't get it. The NES, yeah, maybe the NES Classic can be excused. It was the first thing that they did with this sort of thing, and yes, it did sell really fast, and it could even be argued that you didn't see it coming. But to just blatantly come out and say, we understand the frustration, no you don't, and say that you don't know, that you don't think there's going to be any more NES Classics, and people that are going to have to get their hands on them are likely going to have to resort to scalpers, this to me is not only bad, you know, this isn't bad service to your customers, this is also very shady on your side of business, because, you know, you got to ask yourselves, these are your fans, Nintendo. These are the people that are offering to give you their money. And you don't learn. You simply put, you don't learn. To this day, I'm still trying to get my hands on the free Link Amiibos that came out back in June, which you decided to randomly put up on your website that did not give us any prior warning to when they were going to be up for sale. By the time I found out about them, they'd already sold out, despite me putting the money aside at the end of the month beforehand so I could buy them when they supposedly came out on June 23rd. And that's another thing I want to ask. Why do you have release dates for these, Nintendo? Why do you say that June 23rd is going to be the release date for these Link Amiibos and then open pre-orders a few weeks in advance and then they sell out like hotcakes? What's the point in having a release date if you're just going to be sold out before the things even fudging come out? Okay, so I understand. I realize I may have gone a little bit overboard on this video and I am sorry if I, you know, really screamed into my microphone a bit or got way more angry than I should have done. But honestly, I am so sick and tired of this ongoing problem. And here's another thing I want to bring to the table that I doubt Nintendo themselves are going to listen to this video. This is more just me bringing the attention to people and just adding it on to what other people have said. But here's another thing that Nintendo needs to really realize if they want to keep this problem going on. If this problem carries on and this keeps happening over and over again, people are just going to get so sick of having to deal with the same problem over and over again that they're just going to lose interest. In fact, I've already spoken to a few people in real life or on the internet and I've asked them, do you still care about Amiibos? And I said no. But they've said no, because I'm sick to death of trying to get my hands on them. And by the time I have gotten my hands on any Amiibos I've wanted, the hype has died out, because I've just gotten sick and tired of waiting, and by the time I do get my hands on them, it's too late. The original chance has been passed, and by then, I've just gotten tired of waiting, and when I finally do get my hands on them, it just doesn't feel as fulfilling anymore. And to an extent, I kind of understand, because when I finally got my hands on the Zelda Amiibos for Breath of the Wild, yes, of course I was happy that I finally got them, but I also thought to myself, well, when's this going to happen again? I remember when the Champions Pack for the Champions in Zelda Breath of the Wild was announced, and while I was happy that they were going to be a thing, I also wasn't happy because I thought, well, yeah, that's cool and all, but how am I going to be able to get them? Am I going to be able to acquire these when they are supposedly going to come out? Should I really be hyped for this when it's just going to be another few months of waiting, wondering whether or not Nintendo's going to restock them? And yes, I am aware that in the long run, Nintendo does eventually restock all the Amiibos on demand, but some Amiibos have never been restocked. I don't think I ever recall hearing about the Villager or the Wii Fit Trainer or the Moth Amiibo ever being restocked. I know those Amiibos are old now and not as many people are going to care anymore, but I don't think I ever recall them getting a restock, or if they did, I know it wasn't a lot. So how do I know, even if there is a restock, how do I even know if I'm going to be able to get my hands on them? The fact of the matter is, I don't. What if the demand for this particular amiibo is still so high that despite there being a restock, I'm still not going to be able to get my hands on them? It's all just so uncertain, and it's empowered scalpers. That's another big problem to this. You have made scalpers who knows how much money. Look at the type of money that blooming waste of space Mario to Plumber decided to make. Leo, look at the amount of money he made off of all those Rosalina amiibos because he quote-unquote didn't want the fans to be happy. You know, I mean, I doubt that he actually didn't sell those amiibos. I'm pretty sure he did sell them for ludicrous prices, whatever the case is. But he's just one prime example. You go and look at some of the amiibos on eBay and the prices are ridiculous. In fact, a while back, I actually was looking at eBay because I was looking for a particular amiibo that I may find for a good price. That was a good joke. And I found the Zelda from Breath of the Wild. Her amiibo was over £150. That's just under £100 from the price of a Nintendo Switch. And that's the price of 3 Nintendo Switch games here in the UK. Because over here, one Switch game is usually about £50. This guy was trying to get £150 for this particular amiibo because he knows that they are on high demand. This is the type of stuff that is happening, Nintendo, and you want this to happen? You want scalpers to profit so much off of your merchandise? I'd even wager that maybe some scalpers have made more off of the amiibos than you have. Okay, maybe not, that might be an exaggeration. But I bet they've made a pretty penny off of it. You know, a few hundred quid at least. It's ridiculous. And if this carries on, people are just going to get sick of it. And the same goes for the Switch. But the Switch is even more of a worrying thing, because if people can't get their hands on a Switch, and by the time they do go back into stock, yeah, it could already be too late, and they might have lost interest. Anyway, guys, I'm going to have to go now, because I'm just so sick of this. Anyway, leave a comment down below if you want, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.